My name is Tony, the chef owner of Eagle Gin. Today, we will talk about, learn about, and discuss about pho. Yeah, everything about pho. I hope that we have enough time within 1 hour to cover everything, or at least that anything you want to know about pho, Vietnamese beef noodle soup. First of all, the bones. All about the beef bones. Some recipe, they don't use the chicken bones. In my recipe, I use the chicken bones to add more gelatin. In the recipe, I have 2 gallons of water, just plain water. We have the boiling hot water right here, and we're gonna just blend the bones, because after wash with the warm water, it's still kind of like not very clean for your broth. And the result, you want to have a very clear broth. So that's the reason why we have to do many steps. Boiling water. You put this in. So this one, just cook it until it's like boiling again. And then we're gonna take it out and then wash. Similar to the chicken bones, I already wash this with the warm water. Just wash this and then sieve like blend. Try to get the like the dirt from the fresh bone. Okay. And then after that, we're gonna have another boiling pot. Yeah, we're gonna have the already washed after blend and wash bone. It's gonna look like this. We're gonna have it in the pot and simmer.
Yes, sir.
The chicken, this one, we order from the company, and it's just the bone.
Yeah.
No skin.
No meat.
No meat. Yeah. So it's like the thigh bone. And I don't suggest you cook the whole chicken or the chicken with the meat, because the meat of the chicken gonna be cooked like, let's say, 15 to 20 minutes. It depends on the size of the chicken, up to 165. But the bones, we all about like the collagen from the bone. So you don't want to put the whole chicken in there and take it out when you don't really have any benefit of the bone at all. That's gonna be the best, because you cannot cook the whole chicken boiled in the water within 3 hours or more. Yeah, because you're pouring the part up, and then your broth gonna be cloudy. That's what we don't like, and we don't want in the broth. Just simmer it, don't boil it. Yeah, and then constantly just skim all the scum on top within at least 5 hours to up to 8 hours. And one of the tip, if you want to make this clear as possible for your broth, you're gonna season your salt at least like this step, not like go all the way like five hours and season the salt. No, yeah. Because when you season the salt at the beginning, or like if you season like your steak, if you season the salt and let it sit up for a while, you can see like the water start outside. Right? Yeah. So that's what we want from our bone too. all the dirty things, if any, from the womb, it's not come out. So that's the reason why we want to season the salt before 5 to 6 hours of the womb cooking process. Smell like the bone broth after 5 to 6 hours for sure. And again, we're gonna see a little bit cloudy, dark colors of the bone broth, and that's completely like totally fine. Chicken bone. If you want to just cook 8 hours, and it depends on your beef bone size. If just a small one, it like take less hours than like big one, like I just put in. So if you want to cook just 8 hours, you cook 5 hours for the beef bone, and then you gonna cook 3 hours for the chicken bone. A lot of recipes online, they said that you can cook like 24 hours of chicken bone. Be honest, I don't suggest. You know why? Because even that you just ask me like no meat, but you still see like the meat here and there. Yeah. If you cook it too long, it's gonna boil it for, and then the meat gonna make your broth extremely cloudy. And then the meat, if you cook it too long in your broth, your broth is going to taste different to what it's supposed to be. So if you cook any other recipe, any other dishes, you can simmer up to 12 hours, of, no, 24 hours of the chicken bone and 48 hours of the beef bone, but not for this. And at the beginning, anyone notice that what we did with the bone, the beef bone, we don't roast the bone. Yeah, because when you cook like French dishes or any like Western style like dishes with the sauce from the bones, they ask you to roast the bones for the rich flavor and also the color. Again, the fur here, the broth is not like dark color. No, we don't need that. It's just light color, clear, and the flavors from the bones and the spices that we gonna put in, not the burning roasted flavors of the bone.
Is the beef still in there when you're putting the chicken in?
Yes.
Okay.
So, totally, we're gonna cook the beef bone all the way through.
Okay.
All the way to 5 hours, we add the chicken bone in. For this one, this is the part that we need to add the water like over the bone for sure. But for now, we're going to move to the next step. Turn on the heat for the pan over here. And we have the recipes of the spices on your package. We're going to roast, pan roast this. Everything, yeah.
And it's just dry in the pan?
Yes,
no
oil, no water, no thing, just the hot pan. Just the hot pan.
Okay.
Yeah, so every spices in this recipe, we need to roast the spices to get all the flavors of the spices out. So if you just put it directly to the pot without roasters, the result is not like flavorful broth. I'm gonna stop right there. And if you see this, we don't keep this like this and then put in a pot. Just mark them.